You know, after watching that, people are saying, "Oh my God, he's married with three kids." No, you really don't look married with three kids.
Oh, we started young. You know, when I first moved back into, well, when I moved back, I went away for a year, came back, and found this girl. She's beautiful, one of the most beautiful girls in the country, and I got lucky with her.
So, what about you, Antoine? You don't want to get married yet?
I mean, now I'm hanging out, having fun, you know.
Hanging out, having fun.
Could have saved that for this guy. No,
but is there ever any sibling rivalry between you two? I mean, competition? I'm curious.
Always. I mean, that's what started us out, you know.
I don't know about that one.
No, go on, Anton.
No, I mean, growing up, he's always been the one I looked up to. But yeah. Then, you know, that's what made us strive, you know, to become better. So I'd always have to look for him to push me further. That's what got me into soccer, you know.
So what are you like as an older brother?
Oh, what am I like
as an
older brother?
Not nice.
You know, I'll tell you a story. Growing up, I guess I was a mean brother. I'd always tell him, "Anton, go get me this, go get me that."
Yeah,
this,
bossy.
That.
I was bossy too. I'm the eldest. Yeah,
according to him, it's the older brother powers.
Exactly.
You know? So one year, he got fed up with it. "You have no more older brother powers over me anymore." And he got so mad. And I guess ever since we've just been
close.
Yeah.
Yeah, you look really close. Yeah. But do you give advice? Are you the responsible kind?
Well, I don't know. I can give advice. It's whether or not they want to listen. You know, sometimes you have to see if they're in the mood.
But are you a party guy?
Me? No.
He is.
You're a party guy.
But you're single.
Like to
He's
go out
married.
A little bit.
I live vicariously through him.
So you go out heavily?
No, I wouldn't say heavily. I go every now and then.
You go out every...
Yeah, it's good. It's therapy.
No, but what's it like when you... No, do you drink when you go out?
Not too much.
Not too much.
I keep it limited, yes, socially.
Okay. Yeah, but what happens when you go out? Do women, like, throw themselves at you? I mean, it must be.
Well, no, I mean, it's not really like that. I mean, now it's a little bit different, you know. People ask for pictures and stuff like that. You get a little bit more conversation, but... No, I mean, I'm very, very laid back.
Yeah. But do women give you their numbers? Don't lie.
No.
So does it happen they throw you their underwear, that whole pre-rock star thing? I mean...
I wouldn't go that far. Underwear would be a little extreme, but it would be nice to see. It'd be interesting. It'd be a good story to tell.
No, but I'm sure women give you their numbers.
You get the occasional, you know, occasional number every
now
and
then. Do you ever call them?
No.
You never do. It's scary.
Yeah, of course. You're gonna call a girl that you never met before. It can lead to some dangerous stuff.
No, what's interesting, Armand, is you were also in Askels, but then since you got into a car accident, you completely shifted careers.
Yeah. Well, okay, when I got into that accident, what was it, 2004, 2005? And a bus ran a red light along Ayala, EDSA.
You were driving?
I was driving. One in the afternoon on a Sunday, he ran the red light and hit me right driver's side. So he must have been going really fast.
Yes,
you know?
What happened to you?
I tore a ligament in my knee. I was rushed to the hospital. I had cuts all over. The one thing that saved my life was that right before it hit me, I dove down to the right, because if not, my head would hit the window.
But were you depressed after? Given that you really play soccer.
6 months of pain, really depressing. I couldn't do much.
Okay.
Whenever I'd lie down to sleep, I'd wake up in the middle of the night in pain, because if I turned over to my right side, it would be bad. And months of, every time I'd be in a car and I'd hear that bus beep, oh my God, it's just traumatizing.
You were traumatized.
Yeah.
So what made you decide or choose a specifically different career? Because now you run nursing training center.
Yes. Well, you know what? I figured growing up, I always wanted to do my own thing. I went to the States one day trying to do call center work for my dad.
Okay.
And I found this person that said, "I have this curriculum for Filipino nurses."
She was your dad owns a call center?
He used to.
Okay.
He used to before he moved back to the States.
Okay.
And then, well, back to the nursing, I met a person in the U.S. and she said, "I have a curriculum. Would you like to bring it back?" I brought it here. Schools loved it. And a year later, I put up my own training institution. I'm the only non-nurse in my...
Are you serious? Yeah. How many nurses are training under you now?
Well, I have a database of over 10,000.
So really?
Yeah, yeah. So it's been 3 years we've been running, and I have a lot of nurses.
So they really literally go to class mm-hmm. with you?
It's short courses, maybe 3 days, 5 days. And then now we have a new EMT course. And then they get their practicum with Lifeline. So
Yes. So you have to be a graduate, then they go to you.
Well, I can do both. I can do the undergraduate, and then I can do the postgraduate as well.
No, now I'm curious with Anton. Is this what you want to do professionally for the rest of your life?
Football. I wish it was a long-lasting career, but you know it's very short-lived.
Yeah, for David Beckham, it is. I mean, go on.
Yeah, well, sports. I mean, sports is it's not a long career, you know.
Yeah.
So you have to think of stuff before. That's why that's why we're talking about Sun Life today. Sun Life, you know, financial security,
okay.
And I mean they help out. If you look into it, you know, you can find out. And, I mean. Well, provides you a better future.
I'm so impressed. Yeah, but what would you want to do other than football?
Well, what would I like to do? I mean, you know, I love football, so...
Okay.
You're
29?
Yes, I'm 29, so...
How old's Manny Pacquiao? 32? Something
yes,
like
32,
that, huh? So, you know,
32.
He's counting the years.
Yes. But then, I mean, just like any other athlete, you know, they do what they love, which is playing the sport, and I'd like to stay in the sport, so...
Yes.
You know, maybe start... coaching, maybe opening up a football school, who knows, you know.
Because I'm curious, it must be hard for someone like you. I mean, and everywhere you go, it's like really, it's rock star status.
Yeah.
I mean, what kind of job will you get into wherein, I can't imagine you going to the office. You know what I mean?
Well, what we're looking at now is, I keep telling them, save your money, invest, because we're looking to invest in a restaurant, let's say Masa's restaurant in Greenbelt.
Is that your
money.
Yours?
Not yet.
No, there are people, they're restaurateurs.
Yeah, exactly.
That really earn a lot. Ricky Bengti, Rico Ocampo, yeah. That's a whole.
Exactly.
Yes.
And so just take a little bit of money, invest here and there, so that way, if you make a little bit of money every month from these different investments. Yeah, it's great. And at least it's your money is making money. It's not just sitting around and being spent going out drinking or whatnot.
Yes.
And like we were saying, this look at what happened to me. I got in an accident, I can't play anymore.
Yes.
And so that's why I was lucky. You have to plan for your retirement way in advance.
Yeah, this is very Sun Life.
Yeah, oh no.
This is very Sun Life.
Exactly. I really after the injury, you figure...
But I need to explain it to the viewers because they may not be aware, so they know why we're talking about Sun Life.
Okay.
The brothers are now the new endorsers of Sun Life. So I was kidding, there's actually someone more good-looking than Piola Pasquale on the poster.
Oh, no.
All right, okay. No, but why did you agree to Sun Life, since you've mentioned it anyway?
Well, you know what? It's something from my point
it's
of view, my perspective...
It's a Canadian company.
Yeah, it's a Canadian company. From my perspective, it's... The people that we work with there have been from the top all the way down with Carla and Dom and to the people that run our accounts. They're just really great people.
Are you really Sun Life?
Yes.
Prior to, you so mean prior to the, them getting the you as endorsers, you were both with Sun Life?
Yep. Yeah.
So no way, really?
It's been a great experience. It's been a great experience. We really have to plan for our futures.
Okay. Now, I want to ask Anton, what's up for Askels next? You didn't, I mean, don't get me wrong. You didn't beat Kuwait, which is tough. But then now, FIFA, the Askels didn't make it there.
Yes. I mean, well, the World Cup, I mean, it's a far cry, you know?
Yeah.
You got to take steps to becoming one of the top teams in the world.
Yes.
And the World Cup is the top 32 teams in the world. So, I mean, to jump from, what were we ranked? We were ranked about 180, 190 before December last year.
Yeah.
And now we're down to 150, 160.
Okay.
So, I mean, to be able to make the top 32 teams still ranked at 160, it's like I said, a far cry.
Okay. You know? Now, what would we need to get into that kind of standard?
I mean, we're working on it. I mean, we've taken major steps, and I mean, the team's looking very good. We have a new coach. We found a bunch of other players, new players, you know. So, right now, I mean, it's looking to the future of soccer for the country. That's why we have a sort of semi-pro type league coming up, the UFL.
Okay.
And then we play for a club team called Kai FC.
Okay. And how many hours a day do you practice?
I practice about, with the gym, we go, we have training mornings and afternoons, and then sometimes the gym. So
that's
about
like
four or 5 hours a day.
Yeah. 5 hours a day?
4 or 5 hours dedicated to football.
So that's really everything you're doing?
Yes, pretty much.
Now, I want to ask, they say there's competition, or a little bit of, between the half-bred players and the full Filipino players.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. I mean, we're a very tight-knit team, so there's no really competition between us. I mean, of course there is.
Because all the attention goes to you guys.
Well, no, not really. I mean, like
Chiefy's
out there, Ian. You know, so I mean, it goes to the people who have put in their time in the team. You know, Chiefy's been there. He's probably been there the longest, and he's the co-captain of our team.
Okay.
Chiefy Caligdong. Ian Araneta as well. He's been there since 2002.
Okay.
So I mean, the veterans, they do get their publicity and stuff like that.
Yeah. Now we have a running joke. Why is it that everyone on the team is good-looking most? Is that a prerequisite? No, I'm kidding. Is it? I mean, seriously.
No. I'm kidding. No. putting me on the spot. Making me sweat over here.
No, I swear. I mean, people who play basketball, they're not all good-looking. They have to be tall. But then I watch the Askels and like, where are these people from?
Well, I guess it's a Filipino thing, you know? It's part of
Filipinos
our culture.
Filipinos in general are good-looking people.
Oh, very good. No, you're often compared to the brothers Phil and James Young Husband. They, too, have an endorsement, and you guys have. Is that...
No, I mean...
Phil and James, they grew up in Europe and we grew up in the States. Phil and James have been excellent football players. They played for Chelsea and all that. And you know, we've been here in the Philippines playing locally. So I don't know, the comparison quality in terms of game. I let him thrown down by getting injured and not playing up to where I could have played. If I could have still been playing, that would have been fun.
No, but you know what's interesting? People don't know. Taga Bacolod sila. Diba you're from Bacolod?
We have Negros roots. My dad's mother is from actually Iloilo, Hautea. And so we have family from there.
Oh, so kumbaga you're not foreigners. People think they must be. They're foreigners, but do you speak Tagalog?
I could speak a little bit.
Oh, like what? Sige nga.
Salamat.
May girlfriend ka ba?
Yes, I do. I'm seeing somebody.
Okay, all right. How long?
It's not too long. Not too long.
Like just, what? Just 5 years? Not too long.
Not too long.
Okay. No, you know why I'm asking? I'm sure a lot of women are asking if you're single.
Well, put it this way.
I mean, literally... They know you're single, not taken.
I'm not married.
Over the last few years, he's brought in a few girls home every 6 months.
Oh, good God! All right, yeah, the girlfriend.
So you have hope. You have hope.
You have hope. You have hope.
All right, now,
what will make you fall in love with a girl?
What will make me fall in love with the girl?
Yeah. Okay, I want to ask. Do you want? What would you prefer if you were stuck on a desert island? Tell me, huh? Don't lie.
I'll tell you.
Beautiful, but super stupid.
Oh God.
Or really funny, great conversationalist, but ugly.
How ugly?
Let's just say you're not attractive. What would you prefer? Go.
That's kind of hard.
You see, you know, men always...
That's hard.
Men never answer that question.
Can we ask you a question afterwards also?
Go you.
Oh, no, you go ahead. You have the question.
No, can you answer?
Oh.
Desert island. Beautiful, downright beautiful. Like, you can't take your eyes off her, but super stupid.
Beautiful because you might be able to make her smart. There you go.
No, my God, I swear, you know, universally men have that answer.
No, get the best of both worlds, and you'd be there on that island with me.
Good one. All right, okay, question. Okay, Rod Magaru, Anton also endorses, I can't say the, but I might as well, Health and Beyond, because they're at Sun Life right now. Mm-hmm. But I'm curious, how do you choose your products?
Products from where? Health and Beyond?
No, I mean generally what to endorse.
From what to endorse? I mean, well, it's related to our lives, you know. Health and Beyond is closely tied to my life because, I mean, they deal
You're
with...
You're an athlete.
Yeah, I'm an athlete, you know, they deal with supplements, they deal with vitamins,
yes,
you know, things that an athlete needs to, you know, sustain his body.
Yes.
So, I mean, yeah, that's health and beyond that.
And Sun Life.
Sun Life for, you know, like we said earlier, a sports person's career is short-lived,
okay,
so you got to look further than sports.
No, that I agree with that. Mm-hmm. All right, we'll take a quick break, but when we return, we'll be asking all your questions for Armand and Anton.
Okay, so.